be Dignitas versus Penta. Best of one game, and we are going to be a Mirage here. ESL, ESCA Pro League. And I am Anders. With me is Moses from the ESCA stream, who's been saving me this whole evening so I don't have to solo cast everything. Again, I hope you guys do follow him over on Twitter. If you haven't already, then you definitely should. The link is somewhere. It's JMosesOT at Twitter. So definitely go and do that, guys. What do you think? I mean, when it comes to European teams, I would say Dignitas is like a big up-and-coming team. They're playing really well at the moment. Penta is like one of the most nuts European team out there, because like, out of all the teams that will try like really weird and crazy strategies, it seems like Penta is like the most likely one to do it. I don't know why.
Penta, but they just had the. I mean, they're the ones that swapped with Mouse Sports, wasn't it?
Yes. Penta? Did they spot?
It was like three players. I thought they basically traded three players each team.
Not all of them. I think they just picked up a. Yeah, they did. I mean, I think they didn't take the Mouse Sports players. They just kind of like lost their own, didn't they?
Okay.
Yeah, I think they just kind of lost their own.
Yeah, and Dignitas has been playing very, very well lately. They're one of those teams that, you know, and they, if you look at how they were playing, you know, 4 or 5 months ago, you would be like, this isn't that impressive. And then lately, they've been playing really well. Them and TSM have both stepped up massively in that region. Both teams kind of just playing very good Counter-Strike. It's cool to see, too. Yeah. It's very cool to see.
I mean, I'm excited. I think this should be a fun match. Dignitas, they're a fun team to watch. They've got like young and pretty explosive players. AZ and Kirby are the two most obvious ones, but Nico, when he's on fire, is really well. Pimp has like a really stable level, in my opinion. He almost always shows up. And MSL, when it comes to the in-game leading, seems to be doing a decent job. Penta, like I said, they seem to me like more of like a nuts team. Like, if there's a strat out there where you'd normally say, well, this is too much of a risk for a team to try, like the risk versus reward calculation, yeah, Penta's the team to do it, essentially. I don't know why, but they are.
Perfect. That's always awesome Counter-Strike to watch. I actually had a chance to... Pimp did a Q&A on ESEA a while back, and I got to sit in on it. It was about an hour long, and it was just open questions. And he seemed to me like he had a very good head on his shoulders in terms of, you know, how to play and practice and improve at the professional level. So yeah, I was glad to see their recent successes from Dignitas.
Right. I mean, I would say, like I talked about earlier, one of the problems that I see that is there with the NA scene is like a culture of practicing well, and also of, if not taking the game seriously, then taking your own commitment to the game seriously, like really going all in on it. Because it's hard to really play at a professional level if you're only there like 80% and the rest of you are thinking, yeah, well, you know, I could always go back to school or do something else like that. Those last percentages are really going to come back and hurt you. I feel like Pimp, out of all the people in like the Danish scene, is like actually one of the people who's committed the most to staying like as a professional player. And he's had a hard road to get here as well, in lots of different really weird Danish teams. But now we're actually live here, and look at this. It's one smoke for an A execute, Moses. What do you think about that?
It's going to be for spawn. It looks like that's where Crystal's lined up for at the moment with his smoke.
But that's perfect. That's where AC and MSL are holding.
Yep, and that's the thing. If you're going to play this retake strategy on Pisteron, you have to do some damage. You have to get at least a kill or something as they come into the bomb site.
They don't even drop the smoke yet. Grenade rains in. AC with a headshot, but that's a really big grenade. But look at Dignitas. They're just picking them apart. This last one has to be a headshot on, and it is. That's 5 headshots from Dignitas. Wow, what a shutdown. I mean, that's like the most brutal pistol round of all time, basically.
They didn't throw their smoke at all. I think Pimp has that smoke that Crystal was supposed to throw. That's he has Crystal smoke. So, So neither spot being smoked off, either the jungle or the connector or even CT spawn, and that's just, you know, free kills for Dignitas.
Yeah, that's what we saw. That USPS hiding behind the boxes. I actually love the idea of the grenade being thrown towards the CT spawn there, but the lack of smoke a little bit scary.
Yeah, very, very scary, and you can see exactly why.
I actually think it's possible to not just double grenade that spot, but sometimes even triple grenade it. I think it'd be possible to play a style where you smoke off so that you can throw 3 grenades over towards where MSL is holding right now. Not every round, because I mean, doing anything every round is a bad idea. But every once in a while, I think that trick could probably be employed.
Yeah, especially on pistol round against a team who's playing a retake like that. I mean, two players there, a couple days is going to do some damage. And speaking of damage, Nico's taken down to 12 HP. He's going to be out of this fight. But Stavey does fall.
Yeah, really good stuff. It's, I mean, the fact that the AEC managed to pick up on that kill, especially as he was also dropping a little bit, very important. Now, they're rotating back to where Kiev is. He's got armor, and they've got Tabson with armor, but Crystal there, instant death. Tabson next in line actually does have armor, but can't catch Kirby coming out. Good flashbang in. Still going to be very low on health here. And we'll end up dropping to Pimp. Next in line, Struxy's going to go down choppily with a nice one deke right onto Pimp. That is beautiful, but it won't help him win the round.
No, not at all. And he's just going to be fodder for this bonus money. Oh, he does attack Kirby, so he's down to 9. So now it's his turn to just get out of the fight. But here come the jumping MP7s, and AZ's going to take him out.
Yeah, jumping MP7 is actually not the most impressive one. What's really fucking creepy is that the jumping MP9 is unreal. Have you tried that, Moses?
No, is it really?
It is so good. You have no idea. It is...
It was Chris J with the MP9 at ESCA Land was a beast with it.
Well, I don't know why this has gone undiscovered for so long, but jumping MP9 is really good.
Well, that's something I'm going to have to experiment with, because I did not know that whatsoever.
Well, if you run into it on matchmaking now after I said it, don't blame me. My good friend Rennie put out a video about it. I'll try and link it on my Twitter account at some point here. Kebby to get the good kill in there on Tabson, and is going to go for a little bit more with the MP7. Pimp to be able to kill, and AC will drop one as well. Struxy going to go down, no trouble at all. And this is just working out really well. For Team Dignitas there, surviving with a bunch of members alive. AC hasn't even died yet, neither has MSL or Kierbu, and the other two have only died once, so bit of a slow start for Penta, really.
Yeah, it is, and this is actually, I'm very intrigued to see what they do this round. Pistoron, they just kind of, they didn't get any map control, they just went over straight over towards A, and they executed their strategy, and that kind of scares me on a map like Mirage, where map control is so incredibly important. If you don't have control in mid, it allows the counter-terror so many opportunities to gather information, but... So here they all are spread out. And actually, Trouble is going to be aggressive towards the halls, but they do have that AWP in mid, and that's a nice... That's kind of the meta right now, that smoke at the base of Catwalk. That's going to help them out a lot.
Where are they going to go with it? That's the question. AC is also looking over a smoke in the middle here, just trying to see if he can find the opening, but Tabson was actually almost pre-firing that one. It's become actually really common, hasn't it, for CTs to put up that smoke in lower connector for themselves to try and look over. I guess so common that Penta, they saw that coming.
Yeah, and I mean, also, it's just a little bit of uncoordinated aggression there from Dignitas. KRB also, he peeked up the B halls and just got taken out in a one-on-one battle. So that's 2 1-on-1 battles they've lost here. And Nico's going to do his best to equalize things. He's got one kill, so it puts it in. But look at this. It's MSL. He has so much work to do. It's going to be a 1-on-4 on this execute. And he's in a spot where he cannot fall back or relocate.
MSL hiding in the corner. You're right. He can't do a thing and ends up going down. Oh, what a struggle. Pimp, nice pick off there, but now there are three people fighting him. Nico in CT spawn, not going to get the pick there, and it's already very low, and so is Pimp. They might want to think about falling back from this one, although if they could get one pick off, it'd be amazing. That Molotov, if that had gone down into Tabson, he would have had to run, and maybe they could have picked him off, but Penta's playing this super well at the moment. They're really just playing it safely.
Yeah, not giving anything up, and your idea, there's the save call pretty much immediately. Pimps is going to get away, and so is Nico, but very nice by Penta. I mean, that's the thing. They get those first two picks, and they have so much time left on the clock to manipulate, and you see how it spreads out the defense from Dignitas. You know, one player in B, one player in the window room, and one player over at A. You know, they're just trying to, they have to find information so they can, you know, try and stack somewhere, but just two spread out, that leaves it into a 1-on-4. Nice call from Penta in the mid-round.
Now we'll have to see if they can keep building on this. I mean, already taking a round off of Dignitas is obviously a strong start. And the Danish team, they actually don't have a lot of money. Even though they had those really successful early rounds, they're already digging pretty deep into their economy.
Yeah, they really are. So,
still,
but here's that same...
I was going to say, still no aggressive moves coming out from Dignitas. They're still playing this one very defensively. Although, just as I said that, Nico jumps down his underpass. Thanks, Nico.
Yeah, just to show you up there. And it's definitely, I mean, you know, when you think of aggression on this map, you always think of those pushes up mid by teams like Virtus Pro. I mean, they've just kind of mastered it to the point where it's scary as hell. But, I mean, look at these ops. This op from Crystal really leading the way up A right now. He's being very, very aggressive, and he's going to be able to look into that A bomb site. So Dignitas basically gives up mid control aside from Nico in the window room.
Yeah, and he's just like being pretty careful as well. Doesn't want to extend too much. So keeping an eye. Tabs is going to try and fall back and we'll make it over clearly. Picking up the bomb and Trubly to open up now. They're going to head towards that B bomb site, in fact, with the bomb. Look at the rotation coming in here. They haven't even seen the bomb, Dignitas, and they're moving almost everyone out of the bomb site. Kirby thinking twice, and he has to, but how long is that going to hold up?
Right, and how long until Penta decides to make the move? It's right now. AZ does spray down one, and that's the pressure put onto it. Even KRB's going to fall out of this B bomb site, so this is perfectly timed. But once again, he gets to the kitchen, and he just stops because they don't see the bomb, like you said, so it's all up to him now.
Oh, he's going to be sneaking in. Tabs, and he's got cover bomb Stavros. That's a great position. If he goes down with the bomb, then all of a sudden it gets really tricky. Nico and Pimp, they're going to run away, and they might be running right into the open side of Struxy, who's waiting. Nico gets spotted already. They know where one guy is. Good shot through the wall, but he's boxed in at the moment. This is just a great round from Penta. Really nice style coming out, and Nico's very nearly dead. Tabs and shooting him from one angle. He does actually make it out, but for how long?
Yeah, no, I was not even able to save the guns that round. So that's two gun rounds that Penta's won now, where they got the initial, you know, entry kill or two. They're finding those early picks, and that's just making it so hard on Dignitas to get a good read. So they've really got to find something to stabilize, you know, not giving up those kills so early on.
Yeah, apparently. I mean, that was just a little bit shocking. Normally you don't, I mean, I guess it's not like, doesn't have to be an absolute rule, but a lot of teams do almost live by the rule that until you spotted the bomb, you don't commit to a full rotation. And they almost did that round.
Yeah, they were very, very close. But, I mean, the real issue is Trubly in the halls. He's doing it again. He was just able to walk up and get an opening pick for his team. So now they're lining up for a straight A execute, and it is completely stacked, all five members of Dignitas.
Well, good fashion from Trotley, going to be spraying down Kevry, and in spite of the stack, almost nothing comes of it. Pimp picks off one, and I think he had a grenade to do a little bit more damage, but he's going to be falling back just in time for Strux to be here with the AK in hand, and there's a kill. This is looking great for Penta. They seem like a well-oiled machine at the moment.
Yeah, they're looking very, very strong, especially coming into that stack. I know it's an eco round, but all five members there, and now you kind of get to this point, you're a little bit scared for Dignitas because they have they're in that same economical situation we saw between, you know, Hellraisers and Flipside on Kabul. Is, you know, they have no kits, they have a glass cannon op, so their economy is really, really hurting at the moment.
Some good flashbangs in, but Nico can still see a lot in the middle with this AWP, and they put up the smoke, then wait on the other side for a while, and more smoke screwing out into the middle, which is going to keep Nico occupied here in the room, and actually grenade through on the other side of the smoke. What a great idea. That's really simple, but really cool.
Yeah, that's a pretty cool gimmicky little thing that you can do, and actually Nip does that as well. They throw two nades through that smoke at the base of catwalk, but they throw it into connector to force back any opera that's in there, and I mean, this damage done onto Nico is huge this early on.
And look at Tabson again pre-firing where AC wants to peek out. He wants to use that smoke to his advantage, but he keeps getting pre-fired. Now he's stuck in a corner. Stavros is there waiting for him. He's going to peek out, but there's a double push from underpass. Going to end up taking him out. So a good trade in favor of Penta here. And Dignitas are playing blind almost. They've got almost no info. I mean, Kirby moving up might be the closest they have to a little bit of information, but no one else knows a thing.
Yeah, they've actually fallen out of the A bomb site, so that's kind of smart. They don't have information in middle, so they don't want to, you know, get exploited by anyone coming up connector. So they're going to play a little bit of a retake, although MSL does move into the bomb site now, and that's a good call because the bomb is coming up the A ramp as we speak.
Yeah, he's playing in shadows now. Grenade on down. Chopley's right on top of him, and he's going to end up where Tabson was, going to end up taking him out. And Kirby and Pimp left. This looks like Penta about to take a fourth round in a row as well, though a great headshot there. Crystal trying to get the bomb down and will be successful. Pimp can't stop it. What a 180 though. We'll take out Tabs, and then Pimp is on a mission to try and keep his team alive. Going to switch in for a bit of an up shot there. Crystal in the background though will take him out. And Penta winning another round. Four in a row, Moses. What is going to be the switch up from Dignitas? Because this is a CT-sided map. I feel like, I mean, they're obviously going to eco now, but once they can buy again, what's going to be the plan, do you think, to stop this?
I think it's going to be aggression, to be honest. I think it might be a little bit of a mid-push or maybe a pop flash into the A halls, but they're really struggling with giving up those early kills, so it might be a good idea for them to kind of take the fight to them, because they haven't really done that. And you said it, they're not getting information in the mid round because they're playing it so passively. They lose that player and all of a sudden one goes down, but on their gun rounds, oh, nice shot. A 1D by KRB, so that's a little bit promising, but Penta just responds and starts mowing everyone down. But it is that information. They have no clue how to rotate.
What is going on? Oh my god, that headshot and the grenade timing was perfect. I mean, I thought this was going to be a round where Dignitas get mowed down, but then Pimp just goes mad and gets a couple of kills in there. So you're predicting aggression in the upcoming round from Dignitas to try and get a little bit more information. I'm definitely excited to see if that's going to work out, because it feels like this waiting around style is exactly what Penta want. They're fine with being allowed to set up all over the map. Once they execute, they've been making it work four rounds in a row. That's a pretty good stat.
Yeah, and I think, it's even aggression in the mid round. Like, you know, you see when Virtus Pro is playing on this map, Taz gets really aggressive on that A ramp, and he'll get information when he tries to take battles down there. So, you know, things of that nature, because that's exactly what's killing him in the mid rounds, is a lack of idea of what Penta is doing.
Pimp hoping that someone was going to fight him early on in this 1v2. He does get Tabs in, but with no kit, it's out of time. It's still really impressive. I mean, Pimp is doing a lot to limit Penta's economy, which is already, I mean, at least two of the people are pretty good. So those kills here, the three kills he's got, really huge impact on the rest of the game potentially, if they can start winning. And we'll see what they do to actually make that work.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, and this is going to be a good buyout of him too, though. I mean, they had so much money now that they're getting a lot of that losing bonus in their way, and now they've got a couple kits, they've got smokes, they've got some Molotovs, so even that AWP from Nico, he's finally not a glass cannon. He can actually be a little bit more aggressive and assertive with it.
Going to be in the middle of the jump in from Crystal, and Moses is 1.6 player. I know that has to make you feel good, watching people actually jump into the angles. That used to be a really popular style, yeah.
Yeah, it's actually beautiful. And there's that information gathering. They pop flash over the A ramp. MSL clears it, so they know that no one's over at A. That's why you kind of see this lean towards the B bomb site with two players there. It's only Troubly. These are his halls, basically, this whole half. He's been fully comfortable, but look at the rotation from Penta all the way back towards A now. All five of them are going to be here, and MSL is solo pushed up. He's going to have a lot of action come his way soon, and the question is, will Penta clear it?
I mean, they've got more people than he has bullets almost, and wow, Tabson Crab walks in to get the kill. I love it. AZ going to try and fall back. Dignitas are getting... they're getting schooled right now. Penta's playing on a super high level. AZ getting smoked off, or wants to fight it, trying to play at the edge here. Going to pick up the one kill. Gets a quick double. Nice round from him so far. Puts his team in a 2v2 spray through Crystal. He should have gone down. Finally drops here. And now it's Kirby versus Strux. A chance for Dignitas to get back into this game. Kirby has to win this clutch. And Strux is hiding. He's sandwiched in there, gonna walk in, and he still wins it. Wow. What an upset.
That's brutal. I know. That is so brutal. Bring it down into that 2-on-2 as well. I mean, that's... Penta's doing such a good job of getting entries, and even coming back towards A, you can just see they're really zoned in and focused in this match right now. Troubly, the way he clears that angle, so swift on the shot when he spots him, so these entries are just absolutely brutal. And now Dignitas, they've lost six, and they don't even save here with that losing bonus. They're just like, all right, we have to start winning. You know, we need rounds more than we need to save.
Smoke off towards mid connector. Actually, a pretty damn good smoke. Pretty gonna be... you could probably peek over that a little bit, so not the perfect smoke, but still nice idea from Penta side towards the bottom of connector. And Kirby and MSL holding over towards the A-bomb site. Dignitas have to connect. If they lose this round, it's pretty much all over. Like, this first half is going to be out of their control, essentially. Flashbang in. Nico with a strong pickoff early on. MSL gets one, and Nico picks up a double, spraying through MSL. The perfect angle. I'm looking at the chat. I'm waiting for you guys to deliver the vax spam because that was perfect.
That was very nicely done by him and Nico as well with the first two kills of the op. I mean, it's almost like it's magical. You know, Penta doesn't get the entry kills. Dignitas gets the first two to open up that execute, and they end up winning the round. So these entry kills for both teams are having a huge impact at the moment.
Wow, that was just wonderful. Nice defense. This time, I guess Dignitas didn't need information because Penta was pushing a lot earlier, and they had the right people in the right places already. Now, are they going to be able to pop flash anyone in here? AZ, he's up there. MSL is close by. Here comes the flashbang. MSL is still waiting. And actually, AZ will pick up Tropley. They could go for another flashbang. You see AZ lining it up again. Smokes are up as well. And MSL this time is ready for it, but he does not get the kill. Playing close. AZ sprays down one more. Actually, Nico steals that one away, and AZ goes down. So Nico in the back line here, jumping up right next to the ticket booth and looking for another shot. He's flashed all the time, though. But it's still working out well for Dignitas as they are in a 2v3. And this time they're not wasting any time at all. Stavros, last man standing, gets the kill on the AWPer. And he's still alive back here.
Yeah, he eats a couple meds though. And now he's at a situation where he might feel like he's getting flanked out or pinched.
Stavros making a lot of noise here. So Pimp is going to know, but he does have the bomb. So, I mean, even if he can just get in and put the bomb down, still be a big win for Penta. And economically speaking, it wouldn't be too bad. That $800 bonus is going to secure them a pretty decent buy in the upcoming round. So maybe not so much Staros, but Trobly especially. It was very low on money. $800 bonus and then the loss bonus. Not too bad. See if he can win this fight. He won't. Kirby will take him out. That's not too bad from a 1-on-2. I mean, getting the bomb plant down at least.
No, and it was it's smart play by Pimp, really. He could have taken that one-on-one fight, but that's a situation where if you lose it, you know, your teammate's at such a disadvantage. So he actually gives up that plant, doesn't take the gamble, and just works with his teammate to win that two-on-one. So very, very smartly played by Pimp there. And they do salvage the AWP, so like you said, that money bonus or that $800 planning bonus is going to a huge way for Penta. They're going to have a very strong buy. Crystal with that AWP. And look at, they brought out an auto sniper on Dignitas' side, MSL. He's ready for it.
Yeah, that's the power play now. I guess if you are going to be playing defensively and lacking the information, you should at least have the artillery of an auto sniper. So when they put up the smokes and they really show up, you've got the equipment to knock them all down.
Yeah, so good against the executes that Penta's been doing. The real issue is they've got to find some way now to really make sure they don't give up entry kills. They've got to be the ones to grab them. They can't let Penta abuse them the way they have been.
Ooh. Shot for the wall there, and Nico's already a little bit soft, and AC getting flashed. Got to be careful he doesn't get caught in connector, because that position is going to be vital right now, as Penta are making their way into the middle and through underpass. Are they going to go for a bit of a boost here? Nico is ready and waiting on the other side, but he actually falls back just when they're about to go up. The smoke up as well. Just trying to pre-fire it. Penta, they've got so many weird plays, but it's so refreshing to see it.
Yeah, they have great mid control at the moment. There's four players in here, and there's really nothing these Dignitas players can do to stop it. So you see how far back, how that forces them to play in B, and AZ's not even able to really peek, so he's got to wait for some kind of pop flash, but there's the auto sniper getting in on the action. He grabs Trubly, and AZ and Nico, Penta just falls.
Yeah, and AC went for like a nuts level play. He jumped out of the window into underpass in the middle of everything. And Crystal, though, running wild, coming out of the ladder room and getting two kills. 20 seconds left. Tabson playing up against Nico. Molotov goes up, blocking up Crystal. 14 seconds. That's the kill on MSL. 10 seconds now. It's a 2v2 Penta. They really do not break easily. They've bent really far in this round, but they're still in it. Tabson smokes off one. Crystal's going to spot out Nico. He goes down, and now Kebby all alone. What a round from Crystal. A triple currently. Kebby going to get taken down. His corpse falling back into the flames. And it will be another round for Penta here, 7-5. That was a huge comeback. How did Dignitas lose that round?
That was a 2-on-5. Well, it comes down to them having mid control, because Crystal gets into that ladder room and he peeks through the vent with the AWP, and he has two people in his sight. So he's able to grab a couple quick frags and bring it down to a 2-on-3 before Dignitas can even react. So it's all stems from that mid control they had, and they had players in such good positioning. And that's just brutal. That's heartbreaking. And that also forces Dignitas onto a save. Tabson's going to open up on Nico now.
Wow. Losing a 2-on-5. I mean, when you're playing a best of one, mentally, that's got to that's got to grind you just a little bit too.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And those are those heartbreaking rounds that you're going to see affect him going forward here. And look at AZ. He's even going to get pop flashed. I mean, Troubly over here at A, he's been their lurker, just been anchoring it on the Terra side. He does fall there, but he's been playing it very, very well this half.
Yeah, I mean, even if he falls, it still opens up a lot towards the B-bomb site, where they're now in it. They've got the rifles. They're going to get the bomb plant here, default plant as well. And that's a nice shot from Stavros to take down Kiabu. So, don't know what to say, really. This is just Penta we didn't really say it at the beginning, and I guess now I'm glad I didn't, but I would have picked Dignitas to be the favorites in this matchup. Even by like a fair bit, actually.
Yeah, I would have as well. With the way they've been playing lately, that I've seen. I mean, we didn't say it, but in my brain, that's what I was thinking too.
Yeah. So I'm actually just really pleased to see Penta play, because I don't know, they're playing with a lot of confidence, and they play their own game, right? Whatever Dignitas have been doing to try and throw them off, it's definitely not worked. They've done everything right at this point in time, almost.
Yeah, and their executes and everything they've been doing, and they're not, you know, it's interesting because a lot of European teams really beat up on that mid control, and actually, Penta hasn't put a huge amount of emphasis on it. They have taken it a couple rounds, but a lot of this has just been they've been finding picks over towards B, and they rotate to the other side of the bomb site, and they just execute on a very, very weak and spread out defense. So it's been very well orchestrated by Penta this entire half so far.
Ooh, AC gonna walk right in. Strux looking the wrong way now. The smokes are gonna rain in, but part of this has already been found out. MSL gonna smoke off towards the apartments, making sure no one can come in unless they wanna try and run through. And then look at all the counter grenades going out here. Dignitas sort of, essentially AC and MSL just threw all their grenades in 2 seconds to try and hold back any kind of push going into it.
Yeah, and actually, there's no smokes left here on Penta. Crystal's going to go down. That pretty much confines this attack over towards the A bomb site. You do see Taps and just drop the bomb and check his flank, but this attack was very well slowed down by Dignitas, just blowing their grenades right at the right as soon as the smokes came over the wall.
Yeah, they've got a 2-man lead, and as you said, Penta, not a lot of grenades left, no smokes to try and block off anywhere. This should definitely be around for the Danish team. If this turns out to be an 8-7 type half, do you think Dignitas can still fight their way back?
Yes, absolutely. I'm not going to count them out from that half, but I mean, the real issue is Penta's just hitting all their shots now, all Troubly. If he had gotten that entry, it would have come alive for him, but yeah, I mean, 8-7 is obviously the best they can do, but I mean, the real... Oh, my lord. Tapson.
Yeah, he just walks right in. MSL now behind the box. Molotov is going to force him out. Oh no, he has to move. Ends up getting executed by Tabs. And this is so well. Another headshot as Pimp goes down. Kiabu's going to fall to Tabs. And this is ridiculous. Penta winning a 5v2, now a 3v5 here. They are just out of control. This German lineup is incredible.
Absolutely insane. I mean, you can't even really... A lot of those fights were just great for Dignitas, too. And just the Penta is just hitting all their shots when it's needed.
Oh, this is exactly the sort of round where... Or this is exactly the sort of game where Pimp is going to be super upset, because I bet you him and MSL, they expect a lot more from the team right now. I mean, probably upset him himself as well. Pimp is not like one to just blame everyone else, but definitely really, really a struggle for them. They've got 2 rounds now that they definitely should have won and haven't.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. They're putting themselves in some good positions on some of these rounds, and like losing a 5-on-2 or 5-on-3, that's such a huge swing in the way against them. So now this is, I mean, you can just see Dignitas players just falling at the moment, nothing really to work with, so it's looking like it's going to be a 10-5 halftime score. And that's going to be, you talked about 8-7, I'm not sure if they can do it at 10-5. I think that might be a little bit too much.
It's almost like Penta, they ran into that incredible USPS setup over at the A bomb site in Pistol Round, where they all got headshotted. Every single member of Penta got a bullet to the face, and Dignitas just made it look easy. And then Penta were like, okay, if that's how we're going to play, if that's what you want to do, well then fine. You better bring your A game in that case, because ever since then, they've been absolutely wrecking them. Pimp trying to do his best here in the 15th round, going to go down, and it will be 10-5. With a 17 kills on AC and a quick disconnect for me here, I'm going to get back in the game right quick. But that was a shocking result, to be honest. That was just incredible from Penta. Really well played.
Yeah, that was some really good Mirage play out of him. Looked very, very good. Hitting all, I mean, those two, that 2-on-5 and that 3-on-5. I mean, sometimes when you get in those situations, either two or three remaining members feels like someone has to make a play. So you can see them really, really go for, you know, they just go big into hero mode. But they played it so patiently in those situations together to take over those bomb sites. And it was really, really well done.
Yeah, I mean, something that should almost go back and be studied a little bit, and I'm wondering what they were planning going into this as well from the Dignitas side. I feel like, you know, we're trying to call a little bit for the aggression, and I guess there was the one jump down into underpass. But I mean, if we try and count the ways you could be aggressive on this map, they tried a couple of times as well on the slope over towards the A bomb site and T spawn, where they tried to pop flash on over, which sort of worked, but then they got picked off anyway. But you could go aggressive in hallways. I mean, if they realized right. at some point that, was it Star Wars playing up there alone a lot?
Trubly
playing up there alone, you're right. You could even go aggressive at B. I mean, there's so many options, and all the way to top mid. Did we even see them once try and push top mid? I don't think so.
No, that's what I was thinking too, because, I said that Penta didn't actually put too much emphasis on mid control outside of a couple rounds, and if Dignitas gets aggressive up there, you know, obviously they clear out mid, but that enables them to quick flank on those late round A hits. I mean, it's just absolutely brutal to have someone flanking you so quickly. So it was very surprising that to see how much map control Dignitas allowed Penta to actually have there.
Yeah, I'm really surprised.
It almost feels like they got beat up in some of their early gun rounds. They just got outshot so hard that they played a little bit scared and tentative, you know, really relying on their Opper and Nico in the window to do the damage.
You could be right. I mean, that something definitely happened on this team that kind of shut them down. So not exactly sure what it is. The one thing that I was going to point out, didn't mean to interrupt, but was basically that, historically speaking, it feels like lately Dignitas have been a lot better on the T side than they have been CT side. Like, they seem to have a lot better execute. So I wouldn't be entirely overwhelmed if they come out guns blazing here. But they're going to execute towards A with the same, well, a very similar setup, in fact. Smoke and a couple of grenades here. But look at this. Penta are not in a position where they're going to get smoked off, I think. Not from the one smoke. And they can't easily be grenaded either. So pretty interesting stuff here. Trubly playing in the corner. Star Wars headshot on the first guy. Next in line, AC falls. Great double kill. But look at Trubly. He's behind here. They're going to go for the smoke. They've got no idea. Now he's out there. The bomb will go down. He's a second too late. He's looking for a headshot. Kerry spots him. And oh no. Trubly giving up a big lead. Pimp to take down Tabson. Coming through the murder hole. And he's just not going to survive for long. Struxy now last man standing. And in a 1v3. Looking for Pimp here. The headshot almost gets it. But really he can't win this round unless they make a big mistake.
No, that's tough for Trubly. In that perfect position for the flank, and actually it was Stavros with those two opening kills that gave him the room to make that happen, and just unfortunately they're planning in front of the boxes instead of behind it, or else that was probably very easily around to Penta just because of that play.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. That's actually a good point. Yeah, they're planning out here where I'm drawing right now on the map, but if they had been planning inside, like you're saying, Moses, then Trubly would have been able to walk right out and execute whoever was doing that. So, kind of unfortunate. But I guess it gives Dignitas a great start to the second half. Now they're setting up again outside. Star Wars is playing close with the 5-7, and, well, where's the scout? It's all the way at B, so fair enough. They got two people with the 5-7s within one-shot range here.
Yeah, but nothing, not connecting at all. And Crystal goes down. There's Stavros grabs one. Trubly underneath the balcony is going to get cleaned up as well. So, really, this is another one of those situations where you might as well just call the save right now.
Yeah, especially with the scout, I feel like. Saving the scout and running away with that's not a bad idea. But Struxy gets exploded, and Tabson alone. Could he make it out? I mean, they did a lot of damage to both Nico and MSL in the first couple of seconds, and then they just missed all the bullets from there on out. So, Dignitas making it look easy and only losing Nico.
Yeah, that's both pistol rounds won by Dignitas in this match. So if it goes by how it went last half, they're going to win these first three rounds and then just get pretty much annihilated out from there. But, I mean, to win both pistol rounds, you're putting yourself in a great spot here. And like you said, a T-sided team recently, Dignitas has been doing very well on offense.
I mean, there was a stat in Global Offensive in, like, late 2013 or, like, mid-2013-ish where someone from HLTV, I think it was actually Lurpus, who pointed out that if you win both the pistol rounds, you've got, like, a I think it was like 76% chance to win the game if it's the best of one, like you got to win the map. I'm not sure if that's true anymore because so much has changed, but it's still kind of interesting.
Right, all the ways the pistols have been tweaked with kind of switches that around.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, don't quote me on that one, but at some point it used to have like a huge impact on the game. By the way that the... Troubly! That is beautiful. MSL never saw that coming. That is some next level play.
That's actually massive because the second round buy that they did, you know, going into the fourth round, that usually means you're sacrificing kits or smokes or head armor or something. But with that knife, the extra money it gives you, you know, he's got 5,700, so he's got $700 more than his closest teammate. That gives him a lot of more options in how he wants to buy here.
Yeah. Wow, that's incredible. I just wanted to point out, because from our point of view, it looked like Tabson was on the stairwell shooting in towards the bomb site and was just plain ignoring anyone running in front of him. But that was a smoke bug that happens on GoTV a couple of times. So there was a smoke down right here. Tabson couldn't see the players that were in front of him, just so no one's confused. But that was obviously, that was a beautiful knife. Like, that was almost unreal, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was nice. That was like that was some superhero type stuff, just hiding in the corner waiting.
Ooh, Struxy makes it in. They line up for him, but he can't get the kill. And look at how fast they are right now. Dignitas just charging in and trading evenly at the moment. It was looking good for a second. I mean, it still works out in their favor now because Penta have got to spread themselves very thinly. Tabson hiding in the corner. If he gets this kill on MSL, it could be all over. And there's the bomb down. Turning around, Pimp will go down. That's Crystal coming in from the kitchen. And Nico. Oh, it's hard to make it out of this round with a win.
Yeah, it really is. And it's even Troubly, I believe, is watching. I mean, he's got the AWP, so he can actually pick this guy off, and he does. And he's going to make the jump into the window room. It looks like that's kind of what he wants to do. But, I mean, this is tough. That was so fast-paced by Dantos. They could have slowed down in that 3-on-3. That's what we had seen Penta doing in the first half, taking, you know, those even situations and just slowing things down.
Nico flashing, running through the smoke as well, has the AWP out, tries for a click. Ends up going down. Crystal with a triple kill. And Pentem getting that much closer. They did lose a bunch of people. And Dignitas have enough money and enough of a bank to be able to spread out a buy here. But this is still very scary right now. Because if Dignitas eco now, I mean, if they lose this round and start to eco, Penta could run away with the game, couldn't they?
Yeah, and that's the thing. You have their economy still pretty low. They haven't established anything, so you want to keep these buys going. And actually, if Dignitas wins this round, that's going to be pretty much them right back into the map.
One AWP currently on Crystal. Does spot out a couple of people in middle, but not really going to connect, be able to pick anyone off. There's so much smoke going on right now. And Dignitas seem to be quite set on this idea of actually coming up with a push towards catwalk here. They did throw the smoke to top connector, just to make sure they're not going to get sniped as they make it over into the ladder room here. So that's a really good idea. Like that, use a smoke as well. But Tabson will still push up. And Moses, you were talking about this CT aggression when it was Dignitas playing. Look at what you got here. Tabson pushing in and taking out Pimp.
Yeah, and it's that man advantage, and it's actually a really good thing he did that, because, I mean, this is another situation where, just like Dignitas, Penta gives up a lot of mid control. You see Crystal playing CT spawn with that up, just looking for the boost. So that man advantage is going to be huge, because it's going to let Strux rotate off, just playing for a very quick rotate over towards that A site.
MSL going to be walking in. I think Crystal failed that smoke, but he's still going to get the kill on MSL, who had a grenade out as well, just to make matters even worse. Troubly counter flash out there. Stavros waiting down in Sandwich. Going to pick up the kill on Kebu. And now it's a 2v5. And, I mean, Penta won a couple of these when they were playing T-side. Dignitas not going to do it. Crystal with one more triple kill. And now it's 12-8. And it's going to be an eco round coming out of Dignitas here.
Penta just slowly whittled down Dignitas in that round until Dignitas was just forced into that A hit there towards the end. So just so well played that, you know, once they get that man advantage, playing things so passive and just picking them off one by one, those AWPs or that AWP and Crystal's hands are doing big work there.
Crystal in the middle with the AWP and a lot of people towards the B side of the map. I do love these B rushes because either it works great or they all get annihilated, and I get a feeling this time it's more the annihilation route that we're going here. This grenade from Strux and the M4, the Molotov out, timing. Tabson gets his rifle out in time. Strux is going to try spraying down. only gets the double. So actually pretty good effort here. Although Pimp burns alive up in the apartments. But two kills, not that bad for Dignitas considering the investment.
Yeah.
And a third one. Wow. Very nice indeed. Molotov out as well. Gonna go in towards the site and spray down. Not gonna connect. But that's a lot to get out of it. That's more than I thought.
Yeah, I mean, it comes out. We've seen a lot of kills this in these three matches that we've watched that come from nades being in hands at the wrong times. And there, once again, it's the Molotov on balcony that's just pulled out just a second too late, not dropped quick enough. So it does turn out to be some pretty good trades, but no plant. That's kind of the bummer about it. But yeah, you're right. Three kills is very, very nice damage. It was a nice shot by AZ to get that third one.
I mean, every little thing matters right now if you're Team Dignitas. You need to force Panther to eco and sooner rather than later, and then you just got to keep on training in from here. And I guess based on the success of that round where they just had pistols and they made it that far, and they think, okay, what if we've got all the equipment? Can we make it work then? Tabson playing a different position. Molotov is out already. Flashbangs as well. It's working really well for him right now, but they're getting a little bit too close. He ends up dropping. Stroxy will go down. Great push coming out, and the speed from Dignitas is key, because if they'd been waiting, Stavros would have been behind them. He's already pushing up all the way from T-spawn, so if they'd been waiting another 10 seconds, they would have probably lost the round because of it. But now, you can tell, Penta decided to fall back and just going to look for exits.
Yeah, you nailed it. It was something that Dignitas saw on that B defense, and they were like, ha, we can exploit this with guns. And they just opened that bomb site up so incredibly easily. They threw some nice smokes over towards Catwalk. It really isolated, I believe it was, is that Tabson who's playing Halls, or is he the one playing Catwalk? Whoever was playing at the truck, he got isolated so incredibly hard.
Yeah, I think it was Tabson in the beginning, so yeah. It looked good, though, because I always try and point this out. When you're playing that position where you're sort of jumping and looking into the hallways, there's a bit of randomness to it, in the sense that when you make your jump, you don't know if you're going to be jumping and catching them just as they're rounding the corner, so like just at the optimal time, or if you're going to catch them when they're a little bit closer, right? And if you catch them when they're closer and you make that jump, actually playing that position by truck could be really tricky, because you have so little time to actually make that work. If you catch them right as they're at the corner, usually you can throw Molotov and fall back. But sometimes they're just too close, and I think that's what happened to Tabson. They were just they were just a couple of inches too close.
Well, and you can also see, maybe it's because of how he used that Molotov. You know, they spotted him halfway up. He throws the Molotov, and then he tries to throw a flashbang too. And those, you know, 3 seconds it takes to throw those two nades gave him a lot of time. And now, a nice entry. But here's that map control pushing up through T-spawn to Stavros. He grabs one. Very well done by him, and they've almost traded spots a little bit.
Yeah, now, are they going to figure out? Yeah, they will figure it out. Look at the core coming in. Tabson just has to buy time. Stay alive for a long time, but he won't. Peeks out, ends up going down. Strux next in line, and he's going to pick off AC. Very low on health is Nico as well. It's a 3v3. Bomb is not down yet. Struxy turning around, but Nico is there, covering the backside. Crystal, they almost line up for a double kill then. He's going to jump through the window, and he's very low on health as well. Stavros, good headshot there. Now it's him and MSL 1v1 here. Grenade goes in, and MSL just trying to hide and buy time. Flash to one side, walked right into it. Oh no, and Stavros with a great triple kill though.
Wow, what a retake from Stavros. That was actually really nice. That last shot was beautiful. He just grabs him by the head, and yeah, it was a great call on B actually from Dignitas. It was just, those rotations from Penta came in so incredibly quickly. Crystal doing some damage with the op, and the three kills from Stavros, you know, that's just a fantastic individual effort there at the end. Kind of interesting that the terrorist player there at the end, he chose to pop flash to his right and peek to his left. So that was kind of an interesting choice.
Yeah, you do. You got to wonder if that was if he somehow overstepped out of from behind the pillar or something like that. I'm wondering if what was up there, but either way, it's costing them quite a bit here. Dignitas, they are 5 rounds behind, and another way to put that is that the Penta are just 2 rounds away from a victory here in this best of one matchup. German team just looking incredible at the moment. Oh, look at this Max 7 heat here from Tropley. That looks beautiful. But either way, Stavros is going to be here for kill there with the M4. Goes down to MSL and Tropley. I think they're going to be a little bit too far away for him to use this Max 7. He's trying to use the ladder as well, getting up into apartments, but he can't escape in time. Crystal with a good kill. And now it is a 3v2. MSL and Pimp are 2v2 as he picks up that kill. Bomb goes down in a great position. And let's see if Dignitas can play this after plant correctly.
They're getting Pimp's got it caught in the open. He's got to win this battle. He does. He gets dinked, and there's the trade. Nicely done by Penta, but...
Molotov on Tabson. He throws it in the wrong angle, though. Otherwise, MSL would have been blocked out. Tabson just trying to buy some time. He has faked it once. He's going to go for it. Hold it in. MSL walking into it, and he's going to be there just in time. And they will win the round with 1 second left there on the defuse.
So good. Yeah, maybe triple. Not even a second.
That's so scary, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is.
Well, but do you have an internal rule for when you do those peaks? Do you count to? I mean, Semler and I always say count to three and then peak, because that's like, then you're kind of hitting it. But I guess it's always like, I guess maybe there's a level of intuition as well.
I mean, I don't think I've never counted in my situations. I think there's just an internal clock,
because right.
You just play and you're just constantly grinding those situations out, that you just eventually get the hang of it a little bit.
Fair enough.
I mean, you can always see there are players who have a better read on it than others. Absolutely.
Okay, so let's put it like this: like counting is like the poor man's, internal clock. Then you say it out loud, you know. 1, 2, 3, go for it, go. Yeah, I mean, obviously, you play that situation 1,000 times, you're gonna have a good feel for it.
And obviously, I mean, this might not be if you're committing your thought process and memory to like actually physically counting in your head, you know, you're going to be slow to react to any kind of situation that might pop up. So it's just kind of a feel that you got to get for those clutch situations.
I just want to see a photo of someone at LAN now where like he's
with
in a clutch.
Fingers.
Yeah, exactly. With the fingers out, like, you know, just one hand on his mouse and just like 1, 2, 3, and then back on the keyboard with the hand and, you know, continuing to play the clutch. That's what we need. All right, good stuff. It's 14-11. This match is not over yet, especially as Penta. They are ecoing at the moment, which should give Dignitas a chance to get a little bit of confidence back and just roll over them in this round, especially as they pick the perfect bomb type to go for this attack on. Crystal going to go down here, although he did land a headshot on Kierby, but there's nothing left to do here for Penta except to get a couple of exits.
Yeah, they're not even going to get those. So Dignitas turned it up, although there goes Kierby does fall. But now they know where Trouble is, and he's not going to get anything else. He's actually got to reposition, see if he can find an AK to save or to pick up here at the end.
Trouble. Be nice if he could do that. AC's trying to see if he could deliver one to him, but not quite. 15 health left on him, so pretty close call then. Now it's 14-12. Money is actually decent enough on Penta that they're going to be able to pick up a buy here. Although Star Wars, yeah, there's a gun dropped for him. I was getting worried then, but he does have the M4 as well. Dignitas, their economy is good enough that they'll lose a round and still buy if that happens. So they won't instantly lose the game if they start losing now.
Yeah, and it's kind of interesting that this Dignitas making this comeback, and it's not as dominant a fashion as Penta's first half was, but still, they're making it work. They're kind of just clawing and grinding their way back in, and now look, they're setting up for this A-execute. It's only going to be two players over there, and it's really only one. It's Stavros playing close haul. He's got a lot of work to do, but he has to look the right way. KRB takes it out with a nice entry, and that's the bomb site to Dignitas.
Yeah, Pimp solo on health, but... they've already used a bunch of their grenades. If they could just land one on him, that would be great. And look how far back Pimp is playing as well, being so low. He's just covering the flank. That's not a bad idea. Obviously, you're not going to get grenaded down there. So now Penta. Do they want to commit to it? They're waiting for Dignitas to show themselves.
No, it's a save. It's a save. It was just kind of like, if we don't get a pick in the next 20 seconds or 10 seconds, we got to fall off. So I actually like that call a lot. A really good call from Penta there. So they're going to survive with their weapons to fight another day.
Yeah, I mean, otherwise they would have been ecoing, and that could have actually been almost a chance to equalize for Dignitas if that happens. So, trying to stay alive, Crystal going to be going to kill an MSL then, and Trouble does get caught, so not going to be living through the round. But everyone else will, and we're going to be at 14-13. Bringing it a little bit closer, and that's a pause, actually, so you've got to wonder if that's a tactical pause coming out here from one of the teams.
Wouldn't surprise me if it's a tactical pause from Penta, really, because... Something swapped from the first half where they looked so dominant, and it was, you know, just hitting all their shots, and now they can't seem to find a good read on Dignitas at all.
Well, now the question is, what do you talk about in a timeout like this, Moses? Is it a timeout, you think, to call like one specific thing, or is it just like a general motivation talk? Like, we can do this, guys, don't worry, it's no problem.
I think it's one specific thing. I think it's something that you notice here, and you're saying, you know, let's get that one strat, our favorite most successful defensive tactic for what we're seeing Dignitas do. And let's just get to 15 and then worry about what we can do from there. Or maybe it might even be, you know, calling two strats, you know, to say like, let's do this round, and then the next round we're going to do this something else. But I mean, you definitely at least want to get to 15 if you're Penta here. You don't want to give this one up. And they haven't been able to stop anything that Dignitas has been doing recently. I mean, they're in a 4-round lose streak, so this is a little bit brutal for him.
Yeah, it's starting to catch up to them slowly. And in the back of their minds, I mean, they know that if this turns into 14-14 and they lose all the rifles, they're going to have to eco and play around where, or they either have to eco or force up. So it could be like 15-14 for Dignitas. It's always hard when you lose a game, if you end up losing a game like this where you're at 14 rounds, you just can't get the last two in.
Yeah, that 15th point does at times seem to be the hardest, but I mean, you really hit the nail on the head. If they lose this one and they're forced onto an eco with Dignitas at 14 rounds, that's just brutal, because then all the pressure goes on them to force overtime.
Well, let's see. They've certainly got the equipment to deal with this round. There's a couple of shots going out for the middle there, Crystal not connecting, and they're playing fairly defensively, more than they've been for a couple of rounds here. Still a similar setup over towards the B side. Tabson playing close to truck and Struxy playing inside, though boosted up, which could be a bit of a trick. I kind of like that.
Yeah, that is a little sneaky, gimmicky. So that's actually going to allow Tabson a lot of freedom to kind of cheat over towards the window room or cheat over towards A. You know, trusting Strux no matter what happens to get one, maybe two kills.
And look at Star Wars. Again, the information play like you were calling it earlier, which is a good name for it. Just going to go down, check that no one's setting up out there. Now he's actually going to go out to apartments and find that there's no one there either. So you're going to wonder if this call is going to be coming through now. And look at Crystal instantly rotating on over. So Penta right now, they're winning this round just on information alone, almost. I mean, if they can get a stack of three people in the right place, that's going to be huge. And Star Wars just waiting over here, which is good. No matter what happens now, this is a good position.
Yeah, and they're playing such a passive. I mean, Trubly's going to get the first shot, but he misses it. AZ takes him out, so it's going to be all up to Stavros to do something from this position in Halls.
Well, Crystal goes down as well, and now he's going to come into it, but he gets spotted by Pim. Oh, no! Struxy, the last man left alive. What an upset. That looked like it was going to be beautiful. Nico to take the last kill then. I mean, I don't know. Imagine if Crystal wins the fight, takes out the guy coming in from TT spawn, he gets that kill. Now everyone is focused on him, and then Stavros comes out. This round could have been turned around entirely from that, just those two kills.
Yeah, that's really unfortunate, because like you said, Penta was winning in terms of all the information they had. They knew, you know, exactly where Dignitas players weren't. It was just they thought that the attack was going to come in towards B, and instead it came up connector. So actually, here's a good call out of Penta. They have three over towards A, although Trubly just gives up the opening kill, and that's going to allow Dignitas to just push up through the smoke.
Starros almost getting caught, then Nico following up with the kill, and he's really in a bad position right here. Does get a kill in on AC, tries to move up a bit further. Nico's waiting for him down there, and he jumps off the ledge just as Kepu comes through with a kill. Now Strux is playing a 1v2. Grenade is out. It's 14-14. And Struxy has to try and do this, prevent the map point from going through for Dignitas. But he still's got to take care of Nico. He's done a good job already getting the double. But Nico's ready and waiting, covering the side of that firebox, and ends up taking him out. So now it's a triple kill for Nico and match and map point for Dignitas. What a crazy comeback from Dignitas though in the second half. That's really impressive.
Yeah, it's been fantastic, and it really snuck up on me, at least, just because how the middle of this went. I mean, you look at 4 out of 5 rounds are won by Penta in the middle of this half, but Dignitas just grinds it out. They've been playing it so well, and it's not as flashy as Penta's was, although here at the end, I mean, these rounds are just heavily in the favor of Dignitas, so yeah. Penta falling apart a little bit here in the last 2 or 3 rounds.
Oh no, Crystal caught in the corner here. Smokes up, he wants to make the cross, but a double, triple grenade raining in, and he is gone. Wow. And you could almost tell, you could almost see the terror in his eyes as he saw all those people in the middle. He was like, wait a minute, I can't get out of this corner ever. And then, you know, smoking off to get out, maybe a good call. Nico to pick up Strux as well. And the Danish team, from being behind so far in the first half, have just made a full recovery. Tabson and Trubly, I don't see how they can make it out here. Even if Trubly gets the bomb killed here, there's going to be more people waiting around the corner. He's got the Mag 7. He's got to light him on fire here. Walks in, headshot on one. Now they know where he is. Attempt at a flashbang here, but he actually almost flashes himself, and don't know how that didn't work out. Easy to take him out, and Tabson sandwiched in, goes down 16-14 in favor of Dignitas. Oh my God, Moses, what just happened?
I mean, that's just maybe a little bit of a